Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to translate your WordPress website quickly and easily with one additional plugin. There's no coding and you don't have to translate it yourself. Right then guys, from your WordPress dashboard you need to go to plugins, add new, and in the search bar you're going to type in Gtranslate. Give it a click, and once it loads you're going to click on the first one here, Translate WordPress with Gtranslate. Click Install Now. And once it's loaded, you're going to click Activate. Then you're going to want to go down into your plugins and click Settings. So once the page is loaded, you'll notice in the top right-hand side, that's your preview widget. That's what's going to be displayed on your WordPress website. If you want to change the look of that, you can just click on the widget look button and you can change it to a normal drop down window. There's flags, also just country names. There's quite a lot to choose from. There's a cool little globe that you can select and all the languages pop out of that. So yeah, quite a lot to choose from. I like to keep it on this one because you can customize it more than any others. So working down the left-hand side now, we've got the Translate From button, and that's the language your WordPress website is written in. So if you're Spanish, select Spanish. If you're French, you can select French. That's your base language that your site's gonna load into straight away. Obviously, I'm English, so I'm going to leave it set as that. Pressing on, we've got these next two options, which are paid options, and we're not going to cover those in this episode. We're going to carry on down the list and go to auto switch to browser language. And basically what that is if someone's watching your website in France, say, or Germany, they will have a different base language on their Chrome browser or their web browser. And the plugin detects that that's where they are and it will automatically change it to their language. So you're going to want to keep that one switched on. And after that, we've got the show in menu, and that's where the widget sits in your website. So I like to keep mine on a side menu. And underneath that, it's either sitting on the top left, top right, bottom left, or bottom right. And that's just where it sits on your page. Moving down the page again now, we're going to click on the Show Native Languages Names. And basically what that is, as you can see, all these are written in English. If we select that box, you can see they change into their native languages. And if you click on the widget in the top right again, you can see that every language has been changed to their native name. For now though, we're going to keep it as written in English, just so we can easily identify which languages we're converting to later in the video. The next two options are pretty self-explanatory. So you've got your flag size, we can have it smaller, as you can see in the preview window there, or you can make it larger. I like to keep mine at 24 because it looks neater on the site. And underneath we've got the 3D flag, so we can change that now if we click on flag style and change it to 2D. If you look up again in the preview widget, there's a 2D version and that's the 3D version. And lastly on the top half here we've got monochrome flags. As you can see we've got a CUD flag there, so if we click on that it goes to black and white. Now I like to keep this as a colored flag, because if you've got two countries that have got a similar looking colored flag, once the monochrome is on, you won't be able to choose and won't necessarily be able to identify your flag that you need to translate to. So now we're going to scroll further down the screen and we can see there we've got all our language selections. So as you can see, there is lots of them. And this is why I'd like to keep my native language names as English at the moment, just so we can see which nationalities we're selecting for our menu. All you need to do is select which countries you want to translate to. They get automatically added to your page once you've saved them at the bottom here. So once you've selected all your languages, you can just click the save button and it automatically updates on your website. Now that it's live on my website, I'm going to go into the homepage and I'm going to test it and click German. And there you go, it's been translated into German. So I can do French now Or I can scroll down and choose, I don't know, Russian. Let's go with Russian. So there you go. That's the plugin working on your website live straight away. And it didn't use any coding or translating. This is also fully compatible with any website that you design in Elementor as well. So this page, though simple as it is, I did put it in Elementor, and I can also change it in here as well. So you can see that it's an Elementor website, and it just automatically goes into the top of the page. And I can change the languages here as well. What's also cool is if you have written blogs, stuff like that, it will automatically give that same widget on all of your pages, so you can also translate your blog posts. Now, is it 100% perfect every time? I don't think it will be, and I don't even think the company themselves will claim that it is 100% and foolproof. So you may need a paid version, and that's the pricing structure they've got. It's not very expensive. If you are using it for a more professional website, then I think it's worth spending a little bit of money and not having to do a lot of the translations yourself. I know a lot of the plugins, you have to translate each line individually, while this does the same job but lets the robots do it before you even actually attempt to correct it. So it takes a lot of the initial work out of translating your website, and it's probably just as cheap as the other services. So I think it's worth having a go and using Gtranslate to get your website translated for free if you're just a small-time blogger or you're a company that don't necessarily have the most technical of websites. It will be perfectly simple to use, and you probably won't even need to go for a paid version. Like, follow, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for future videos.
Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.